Hello everybody and welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are on the way to see how to run Warpath on your PC. From now you can watch it on your screen. It takes almost no time to effortlessly download and set up Warpath and play the game on a Windows computer using our gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. So it's time to have fun, let's go! First of all mates, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite web browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's go to the next URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type it, because I provided the clickable link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived there on our own internet site of Usitility, at which we have a precise information on how you can download Warpath on computer. We browse down a tad and mouse click on the download game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will use to enjoy the game Warpath on our PC. It is now obvious that we get several pros of running that emulator. Then, we are ready to start downloading the Warpath by simply clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. We then click on it. And the download action takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to run the executable file, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the system. We have clicked yes. I reduce the internet browser to start to see the installation software better. The installer is very easy to use. It is made up of a couple of possibilities, install, and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path truly does. We just click on it. Therefore, we note that we display here the path where the emulator can be installed. If we would like to vary this directory, we must click on this Browse button. Therefore, we opt for another directory and set up the emulator exactly where we desire. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. I simply click back. So I simply click install. Voila! The setup commences and it is going to progress with the download of those MB which are shown on that screen. The time you download it, it could be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed may go faster or at a lower speed, subject to your connection and according to the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Right now they are running extremely fast. The download is finished, and so instantly it continues on with the setup phase. The installation is going to take more or less time depending on the power of your computer or laptop. The more efficient it's actually, the shorter the software installation time and vice versa. If we join the download and installation step, it will take a very long time, so have patience. It is by now completely finished for me. At this point, the emulator happens to be started on autopilot. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar which will fill up and when it actually reaches the finish, the emulator is going to be launched for the very first time. The fact is the emulator was already started, there for the very first time. Before we carry on, as you can see now, it created a couple of app icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is definitely the one we are focused on. The moment we would like to operate Warpath on the PC, we double-click on this particular software icon and consequently use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even anything like this. The reality is, it is an icon that we may very likely never ever utilize. We should perform the next phase, which is actually a must-have, and that is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. As you can see now, the Google Play has started. In this case, we have got to log on. At present, as soon as we're right here, we must absolutely do the following step that is mandatory. Therefore, we simply click on Sign In. At this point, it shows Checking Info. It might occasionally get stopped at checking info, and it doesn't advance. If that's the case, you could attempt to connect to your account after a number of hours and it will most likely be solved. At this point we're going to type our email and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email address and its corresponding password. For instance, you could use the same exact email you are using currently in your YouTube account. Therefore, I am going to provide my info and I'll revisit immediately after I have completed it. That's all, details typed. Find out Google welcoming us and presenting us the terms of service. We should approve them simply by hitting, I agree. After that, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You might keep it checked and it'll build a backup of the files on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can utilize this option if you want. We just click on accept. Google Play Store is launched without need to open it manually and on autopilot. To set up the game, we must browse the Android emulator desktop by clicking on that icon indicated green colored. Today that we are watching the desktop of that emulator for Android, we can see that we have right here the install application button. We click on that button. Right here we have got the Android game. How about we mouse click here on the install option that I am just displaying now in green. Therefore it will commence the software setup. Right now it is going to download on your PC and set up the game app. It will take a while or it might possibly be almost immediate. It again all relies upon on our own web connection. It's already completed setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by pressing the following option I'm highlighting in green, so that you can start Warpath for the first time. Shall we simply click on this My Games choice just above? We're now on the emulator desktop, and then we are on the way to click on that brand new Warpath app icon that has been generated. This video game is started for the first time. Here we have it. I could press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should discuss the sound level of that emulator. This is here. We have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This way we will not rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we should activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. That is actually the very first one. We simply click on that icon that I'm identifying in green. Then the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. Supposing that we would like to launch the app using all the screen, we click this particular game icon. And we'd without a doubt be experiencing and enjoying the gameplay in full screen setting. To quit the 100% screen mode, click the F11 key. And we might just play in standard screen mode. At this moment I am choosing to clarify you the keys mapping and that is quite helpful. This way we may be capable to play the game application much more effortlessly. The first point is to click on this computer keyboard icon. And here you will be able to complete the appropriate setups. I am going to keep the standard configuration, but if you wish to modify this, you may very well achieve it without having problem. Clearly, the emulator is entirely in our own language. On occasion it occurs that the emulator is started in the improper language, as an example, in Chinese. Then to place it in the appropriate language we click here to the cogwheel. Then there throughout various other configuration settings, we click on the language drop down. We may select the language we prefer, English, Japanese, and so on. As soon as the language is determined, we should save, the emulator will restart, along with the game, the next time we start it, will as well be in the specified language. At present, there's another point that we need to take into consideration, and it is that we will receive an email telling that a new machine has been linked to this Google account. It will likely ask us if we're the ones who have connected that device. Of course, we ought not be troubled, considering that the emulator is behaving like an Android smartphone or tablet. And then to find which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we come back here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. So we go here to the model selection. And there we realize that the emulator is emulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for my video tutorial. I hope that you liked it, particularly that everyone found it useful. In that case, offer it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe to the channel, and if you have comments, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment field down below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams occasionally, you have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click any of these online videos that happens to be showing up on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the next instructional videos. Bye.